made him feel slightly henpecked.
"And just fancy," she said, "they have no means of knowing if he has arrived safely on the German side. How can they know he is a prisoner without knowing that? But the word is missing. That means a prisoner," said Letty uncivilly.
13. Mr. Britling returned to the Dower House perplexed and profoundly disturbed. He had a distressful sense that things were far more serious with Teddy than he had tried to persuade Letty they were, that wounded and missing meant, indeed, a man abandoned to very sinister probabilities. He was distressed for Teddy, and still more acutely distressed for Mrs. Teddy, whose every note and gesture betrayed suppositions even more sinister than his own, and that preposterous sense of liability, because he had helped Teddy to get his commission, was more distressful than it had ever been. He was surprised that Letty had not assailed him with railing accusations. And this event had wiped off at one sweep all the protective scab of habituation that had gathered over the wound of Hugh's departure. He was back face to face with the one evil chance in five. In the hall there was lying a letter from Hugh that had come by the second post. It was a relief even to see it. Hugh had had his first spell in the trenches. Before his departure, he had promised his half-brothers a long and circumstantial account of what the trenches were really like. Here he redeemed his promise. He had evidently ridden with the idea that the letter would be handed over to them.
"Tell the Bruddykins